First of all, I'd like to thank you for watching the show. And some of you may know me, some don't. Very frankly, this I did not start my career as a glass man here. Actually, my company now is 21 years old, and I started 22 years ago. I don't know anything about glass, frankly. And I was a trained industrial engineer. I've been working for 14 years in Canada as an industrial engineer, working for Steelcase, Herman Miller's, and Phillips, and all this major corporation. And I started the business from a hobby. We did a lot of shopping mall plazas, ceilings, special effects, using more engineering technique, more high-tech thing than just the good look. Now, in the past many years, we have done a lot of projects across the country, put it this way. And currently, we are doing a lot of donor recognition panel, donor recognition walls for different institutes, from hospitals, college, and other charity institutes. We are still classified, we are still relatively a small company, and but we will be expanding as we will be relocating ourselves to a little bit north side of the city. At that time, we will like to introduce more of our technique and technology into the trade. In the past many years, I deal very closely with interior designer and architects, mostly in our glass product, stretch all the way from building product to premium incentive like award and crystals kind of things. Now, how does it lead? It's very unique because the linkage between the two totally different type of product line is bonded by a technology, and we do special kind of etching, sandblasting, carving, and also create different type of safety glass type of nature. We produce the safety glass in-house, and we do forming, casting. We bend glass a little bit, we create new breed of product, new breed of glass, put it this way, for different application. This make us very unique, and this is a niche market. Now, as Stuart, as we walk along, this is in my office here. We got a lot of history here around the past 21 years. Now, as we move on, you will see this particular photo here. We have many photos put together. This how I also get involved very strongly with the community. And this particular case for the Yihong Community's nursing home. And you can now you can see a lot of people, a lot of famous people you recognize, and a lot of things we create by using different kind of crystal, different kind of technique for the gala for different years. You see Joe Clark here, Bob Ray, different people you probably recognize who they are. They are still in the office and out the office and so on. We also have a write-up a couple years back from the Canadian Homes, and very nice of them. They got 5 pages for me. I don't have to pay for it either. Some of these from the community, you know, the Chinese community, the newspaper, and so on. As we also move along a little bit here, and this is the part, a lot of mainstream community also involved. This is why bring me to the attention, we have to create something for the donors, and they do all the charities, and that's how I got involved a lot. Now, some of you might recognize Daryl Sittler here, working with IBM project at one time. You see the hockey star, of course. And then up here, you have also Archbishop Desmond Tutu. That's when we support the South African Women for Women. Some of the church trip we do. Now, as we move along to the other side of the room, you see some very famous people here. Mayor Carson from Markham, and I was the mayor of Markham for one day. Just one day. and we have some funding for charity purpose. Now below there, you see our $1 million models here, Cindy Crawford and Claudia Schaefer. Now this is data way back to 1992. In fact, we do a lot of award for the Revlons at the time, and Cindy Crawford and Claudia Schaefer were the key people. One of the technology we have, when we do sandblasting and carving, we can actually get the photo of the person carved onto glass, granite, or stone, or whatever. Now, at the time, I said, well, we'll create a crystal business card for Cindy or for Claudia. I said, in return, I want some photos, a signed photo to put it in my office, and then we did. Now, I want to show you a little bit about the technology of our sandblasting carving. As I said earlier, we can have the photo carved onto glass. Now, you can see very well here. You see the detail? It is actually from a photograph they sent to me. This particular technology has been on for many years. Somebody's tried to tell me they can use laser to do it, but laser cannot actually do it. The only laser you can do is you see those crystal blocks, they actually have a different kind of laser. The regular laser CO2 would not be able to give us a crystal finish like that. Now this technology, after we move next year to a new premises, we probably will introduce this technology to the trade. So I hope more people can use it. It's quite interesting. Let's move on to the next one.
I just have a quick question about that. So are you going to be letting the general consumer come in and maybe do a photo on glass, or is this more of...
Yes.
Okay.
Now this is different than the one you see at a shopping mall. They take your picture, put your photo on the mug. The one in the mall is actually they produce a decal, like a sticker, and the decal they go through a little quick treatment that they will stick on your coffee mug or a piece of glass. Otherwise, this is actually carved into the glass, so this is very permanent. Now I have also introduced, for a very short time, briefly, to the cemetery industry, and we can carve in something like this. In fact, these are my grandparents on my mother's side. These photos were over 100 years old. And we just clip it there, and what you see here is 1/2 inch by 1 inch of each of these photos. So it can be done very high-tech, very effectively. And again, this is carved into the granite. There are many ways of doing things, and just we look for the right way and the most cost-effective way. And I will later on show you our plan there, how to produce special texture glass, and also show you what tempered glass, laminate safety treatment of the glass, what is all about. Let's move on a little bit here. And these are some of the projects. Well, of course, this is our involvement politically at one time with our Prime Minister. Also, Iron Rose supporting different type of project we have. This is one of the very exciting project we have done. Some of you may recognize this place. This is the ceiling of the Royal Ontario Museum, the old museum, the main area. Now on this side, you will see this ceiling is in Switzerland. Actually, this one, we have a Swarovski crystal at the ceiling. It's a fair size, it's not that big, but it's quite interesting, very elaborate. This was many years ago. These are the type of crystal of what we can do. And what, when I say we can do, I mean we do it in-house. That goes through a process of bonding, ultraviolet bonding, metal, crystal, and wood. So we are using a multi-level of things. Now you see, I have a piece of glass here also. I'm talking about a little bit of high-tech things that are introduced what we do. If you can take a look at this, now you see me, now you don't. Now you see me, now you don't.
So that is, that is really amazing. To be honest, I don't understand how that works. I remember you showed that to me before, Ron.
Now, the important thing for us, even we talk about a 21 years old company, we have to keep up our knowledge, our idea, our vision to the new generation. The new generation is a computerized generation. Everybody talk about high tech, talk about LED, talk about fiber optic, talk about all kind of specialty things. So this is one of the specialty, one of the new thing in the world. What it is just two pieces of glass with a special film in between, laminated together. As I push this button, current passing through, and you will see what is behind. It's a change of the iron inside. Now, you might have seen some of these in the movies already, or some of the interior designers, especially they've seen this, they use for washroom, use it for changing room, especially one of the, I remember one of the CSI episode also used this for the washroom, a girl get kill or something like a fight inside. You've seen it, but we also use this for office. Another thing you can use it for is also because it's frosting at nighttime. If you use it for the window, then we can project image behind it for advertising purpose. So many way of using thing, and we have this product available for you. Let's move on to the plan at this point, and let me show some of our process to you. Hello again. Now this is our small place here. What you see here are the genuine glass. What this is when the company, the large company, when they go through a process called the tempering, we safety treat the glass. Now some of you may know when we safety treat the glass, especially the tempering, we are sending a piece of glass going through a furnace at a high heat and cool down very quickly so that the surface tension is very strong and the tempered glass will be 5 times stronger on the surface impact than the regular glass. And to make it more straight is what we call the laminated glass, is put two pieces of glass together and with a film material, bond them together so that by the time they break, they don't shatter. This is like your car windshield, that's how it goes. Now what these are, when they go through that tempering process, the glass blew up and fell to the bottom of the furnace. Every 10 years or 5 years, the big company will take this out, like chisel them out like big rocks, and give it out, or sell it out in this case to other purpose. Now in the past many years, you see some of the Eskimo artwork, you'll see these kind of glass they chisel and carve into different animals and Eskimo things on it. And also your fish tank, somebody might use this in fish tank. As you can see earlier, it's very, very interesting. Now at the moment, we're using this glass for the contemporary kind of garden effect. Contemporary garden in this case. As the sun shine up here, this thing just glow. At nighttime, you put a light behind, this thing glow. Very, very unique. Now, one of the process we our company do is casting and forming. I'll show you the process a little bit. And behind me here, you'll see one of the pieces we create. A lot of this for display or partition purpose. And also, we can use it for different application. As we move down here a little bit, table. We actually can create a texture type of glass, a new texture, and then we will form it. And some of you may have seen this kind of face. This is what our major part is to be using this for. You can buy this very cost effective now. We'll use this in the first time. Cost effective for this. It is interesting, it's a very custom built thing. And in this case, we will have a round mold and we will have to form a piece of glass like this, a different texture. Then we form the shape. I will show you, if you walk into one of our rooms, to show you a little bit about the process. We have a piece of glass, we cut it to size and create what form or shape we wanted. Now this is one of our small room here, one of our small cube here. And let's see what is cooking. Ah, okay. Now it's cool enough to open it. It takes a long time. If we do a larger piece, then it takes a long time for cooling down. Still hot. Now as you can see this process, this piece is about 50 inches by 28-29 inches wide. We have a mold at the bottom and to create a texture, and this is how we do these kind of things and different form, different shape as we do. We also do bent glass, what we call bent glass. It's a curved glass. We'll show you a few pieces in our showroom. It looks very sophisticated, but the basic principle is very simple. I'm going to show you some very interesting process. In this particular area, we've got two workstations for the sandblasting or etching. And in-house, what we do, for what you see so far at the different kind of photos and all this bit, we are producing the whole thing in-house. First, use the computer to do a layout, do the design as we wish, and our computer will produce a master. And here in the next room, which I'm not going to show you, we will produce a rubber material that will overlay onto glass, metal, stone, whatever we decided to, and then we go through a sandblast manually, sandblast process. Now, here is a unit, what we call curtain. As you can see, this thing can go up and down. This particular station can do a panel of 10 feet to 12 foot sized glass. Now inside, we are preparing, now you can take a look. Inside, we are preparing a piece of panel for the Royal Ontario Museum for their current show of Cyprus. What we do, behind me, this is where the abrasive, the so-called sand, but actually it's aluminum oxide in different grades. So this, when the air pressure comes in, this is the gun, the person can stand, and then we'll point to the area that we decided to chisel out the material. And in that case, you see the purple rubber, which is actually a rubber that bounces back the sand, and where the clear area, they will chisel into the glass, and the end result will be the indent will pick up the light, and then they'll glow. This is what we've been using for different panel, different effect. For donor recognition wall, for individual awards, it's all the same, similar process. It sounds so simple, but it's not very simple. There's a lot of high-tech thing involved. Now, different station, we have a second station on this side. We are using a different kind of abrasive. The reason for that, we cannot mix them up. The different abrasive give you different texture and give you different sparkle. And this is the, we have four stations here working on these kind of projects, and they are very sophisticated in some of them. Now let's move out to the showroom. Now on the other side of the showroom here, we're showing some of the work we day-to-day we do, and one of the product line is the awards. from the same technology we introduced just now, we can go into different large or small area. You've seen the Neptune there, and you see a lot of these award and gift item, memento, wedding, golf things, and you know, for the golfers, you know, this is very exciting. It's basically the same technology and bonding and special effects and different carving and the artistic part of it. Now, we briefly talked about the tempered glass just now, like your car windshield that shatters. Now, here, you look at this table base we have below here. You see the sparkle. We have been doing this for quite some time now. And actually, what you see is three layers of glass, two regular glass on both sides, and a tempered glass in the middle. As we laminate them together, and we break the temper as we polish. So now it becomes a safety glass, and in this case, we are talking about a 3/4 inch thick, and then we bond them together as a base. Now we can apply this for a coffee table in this case, but also can be dining table. Now we'll move over to this side. Something very interesting I'd like to introduce to you. This is the next generation. What you see here is what I call a flat light bulb. Now I'll show you what it is all about. Actually, no words of a lie, this is a flat light bulb. A new technology. Now, that's all it is. So we are using this, our company is OEM on this product, and we will use it for different kind of display because it's easy to carry, and we'll use it for lighting effect for different panels, and especially this is easy for us to take it to the trade show. So this is the next generation. This is similar to an LED type of environment, but it is not LED. Let's move down further on this side of the room. You have seen some of these specialty glass. Everybody asks me if this is a fish tank. It is not. Actually, it is a glass column we create. We're just showing the detail that we can do for even the leaves here. We are carving it in both sides. Now, behind here, let me move down this a little bit. You will see some of the photo we have. In fact, this particular ceiling line, which we have done many years ago, I would say 20 years ago, this is called the Eaton Sheridan Place at the time. Still there, Aaron Mill Parkway and KBW. At a time we create special effect for shopping mall, shopping plaza. We did about 22 shopping mall plaza, and this looked like stained glass to you, but in fact it is more than stained glass. We used the art glass and modified that to safety glass at a time. And the first one started to take that approach. This is even before the laminated glass come into the tray. Now let's meet our old friends again, as we talked about earlier. Cindy Crawford, for the carving, the what we call the photo masking process is actually a photograph carved into a granite, black glass, and rocks, and so on. So this is how nice it can be. Now, so much for the premium incentive and awards. Let's talk about something more interior design based for your building, for your home. One of the unique thing we have, if you see this particular surface, and people now use this kind of surface for your kitchen counter, like breakfast room, and this come out, it's a German design for this pole, and it's Hefler design, and they just raise the top, and then you sit on this kitchen counter for your breakfast, and it come out like a foot. Now behind also is our sliding panels. Now, a lot of room now we do for residential. Instead of using an open and shut door format, we're using the sliding door because number one, it saves a lot of room. It's a trend, but it's not, put it this way, it costs a little bit more, but it's very, very unique. In between, also, you will see this type of system, the cable, the rod and cable system, which you can use for display in most cases, but also you horizontally you can use it for different shelving. In fact, at home, I use the same system for my computer desk. Actually, I have my desk and I have a cable system right by me. I have the printer, everything in a different layer, so you save a lot of room, especially people live in a condo, a smaller room and so on. So you are wasting a lot of space in midair. So by using a certain system to have a little bit the design, it will look very, very nice and very effective. This unit or equipment are actually floating in midair for you. Now, over to this side, this is how the craftsmanship and artistic things come into the picture. What you see here, and let me show you, a very dear friend of mine, she have an oil painting painted at home. I love this painting so much. Then I say, okay, let me take a photo of it and I bring it back to my shop and have my artist do a carving by a different interpretation with different media, we call it, by interpreting this painting on glass. Now, what do you think?
That looks amazing. So it seems like you could just take anything, any type of image or photograph and apply it to glass and totally change the look of it and make it a very unique
Pretty well, because from an artistic point of view, is instead of using oil and canvas, we use glass and sand. And like anything else, from a designer point, we are creative people. We like to be called creative people. And it's not just the good look part of it and what you can do with it. Now, by doing so, instead of just a painting on the wall, I can use this as a partition. I can, as you can see here, I'm using it as a railing panel. And it can also be a piece that fill in your space in between your room, like a cafe, somebody have come into the entrance, or between the people see our living room or the draft coming, we have some cover. So this can be the media. So we are the specialist here in this case to show you how to maximize for your facility planning. Now I'll show you a little bit more. You see, just keep talking about the artistic part and so on. I'll show you more something more extreme. And this is the glass flooring I want to show you next. Now here the special flooring, as you can see, and my shoes is not very nice, but however, you can walk on air. Now by ordering special kind of flooring, you have to be careful. We have to go through a engineering structure consultation to you, but it is very exciting and it can be done, and depends how. What area and what structure you have. You have seen, some of you may have gone up to CN Tower, and those are very, very heavy duty glass flooring. This is something you can do in your house also.
So is this the type of tile that they would have many tiles like this making up a whole floor? Would this just be like in the center of the room on the floor?
It all depends, because we have done several places for people use it for their bathroom. And don't forget, we have a frame here for each panel. And we have display or carved the panel, as you can see. Some of this, you've seen those rocks you have there. You can actually put something underneath there and have some lighting. And to make it very, very unique. And people always like to walk on air.
Yeah.
And it's very, very unique. As this type, you know, you can see It's quite unique. You can put anything underneath for commercial use, and people will take this advantage and say, oh, you know, that shop I went to, Wenhu shop, they have this glass floor, we walk on it. So it's like a marketing purpose also for merchants.
Yeah.
So don't forget, every time you pay a special design, pay for the price, it should be an investment instead of just doing something for you.
That it does look very amazing. It actually looks like you're standing on water, kind of, because it looks like that could be the rocks at the bottom of a stream or something like that.
Yeah.
And that
the same application I mentioned for flooring. Obviously, as you said, you know, we get different level, different thickness. And in the same process, we produce bullet-resistant glass for the bank, for diplomats' place, and so on, for government. And that is adding multi-layer, multi-thickness of glass together and to create the barrier so that the guns and bullets cannot go through. The banks use it, some, you know, different kind of application. And we can produce that too. But also some of these glass are now as massive produced by the European, American, so we used to produce it in-house, but we don't do that anymore. And relatively, they are cost-effective. They're not that expensive, but of course it's more expensive than a regular glass. But that would be something interesting to people to look at for the house, for the stairways. The people use it for stair, for this kind of floor, not just a plain floor. You might see this also, William Ashley downtown, in fact, one of the showroom, they have one, I think it's on the second level, and they have this glass floor, and they put China's inside it. It's like a showcase inside the floor. Now, we showed you from the sandblast station, that particular piece for the Royal Ontario Museum for this Cyprus show. This is the end result of one of the panels. As we finished off, you will see actually they have a show right now at the Royal Ontario Museum. You should go take a look. And this is the end result of the map, the names and everything, different layers of glass put together, different carving. The carving will create, as you can see, the edge glow. And this is the special effect we create for them. And this is why I earned this respect. This is the award we have from the Chinese Canadian Entrepreneur Award I received a few years back.